Hey everyone, welcome to this week's episode of The Art Bastards. I'm Cassandra James, and we're joined, as ever, by Jeffrey Chamba Cruz.
Hello.
Chris McQuinlan. And this week we have Thrashwolf.
Woo!
And Martin Abel may be joining us later in the show, but to start off with, it's just four of us. And we have a question for this week. The question is, what was the first milestone you reached as an artist that made you think, huh, I could actually make this work? As in making money off your art. Who wants to start? I know you guys are thinking about it.
It's tricky though, because, I mean, nothing, no real moment was like, huh, this is actually paying off. It's more so, I'm going to do this. Let's see how it goes.
Yeah, I feel like I'm the same. It's like there's no real defining moment. It's kind of like you dabble and then you're like, hang on, like I could, like this is enjoyable. I get to draw all day and enjoy what I do. Like, why can't I do this for my living? And then you kind of make it work.
Yeah, I get that.
For me, I was meant to be buying a house and it went to shit, like really south, and got stuck living with my parents and then my sister for like 6 months. I'm like, well, I'm not paying rent and I've been wanting to draw for a living for a while, so I might as well fucking take this chance, seeing as I don't have any like direct like debts in my current future. So yeah, that's pretty much how it happened for me.
Good stuff. Well, I like when I first kind of took the plunge into doing art and design, like I was living with my brothers. I'd just finished uni. I was working at a bar as at like actually like three different bars as a bartender. And then I just got sick of having to deal with, you know, like people in probably like the worst states that they're ever going to be in. So like really drunk idiots. And so I was like, you know what? No, like I went to university to go and like study art and draw and, you know, enjoy like creativity in the creative process. But it's like, all right, well, I'm just going to give this a shot. And sure enough, it's stuck. And turned out I was living across from a freaking screen printer who was amazing and pointed me in the right direction. So I would give him work and he would give me work and kind of fit that's off each other that way.
Oh, wow.
That's really cool.
It was pretty sweet. It was a good deal. And like even to this day, like we still keep in touch. And like I always shoot clients his way that need to get stuff printed. And he always shoots clients my way whenever he can recommend me. And like, yeah, it's good.
That's fantastic. I guess for me, I always knew that I wanted to do. Oh, yeah. I wanted to do something.
How about you, Kat?
I was preemptively answering you. I always wanted some form of art career. I didn't know what. When I was very young, I thought I wanted to maybe be an art teacher. Did anyone else have that at all? You want to be an art teacher? It was just, no? Okay, well, maybe just me. But then as I got older, you know, sort of realized that, well, one, I don't really like students, that, like kids that much. I'm sorry.
I hate people.
Yeah, by the way, don't be a bartender if you already hate people. Like, it just solidified my whole idea of people suck. All right, cool.
Not doing this. So you wanted to be an art teacher, but then you stopped that.
Yeah, I stopped that. And then I went to art school and hated it there as well and left when I was offered a job doing art. So that's what I've been doing ever since. And it was funny. My first day in painting class at art school, we sort of all went around a circle and introduced ourselves and sort of said, oh, why we wanted to be at art school. And I went because I wanted to improve my drawing. You know, I wanted to be either a comic book artist or a fantasy illustrator or something along those lines. I knew it was what I wanted to be, but I needed to get to the stage where I felt like, you know, I was good enough. And I felt that going to art school was going to give me that. And we're all going around in the circle talking about why we're at art school. And I say, well, hey, I'm here because I want to get better at painting. You know, I want this to be my job. I don't see the point of having a career that you don't absolutely love. And my painting teacher laughed at me and said, you better marry a rich lawyer because you'll never make a career off doing art. And I was even thinking to myself at the time, well, aren't you an art teacher? Haven't you made a career off art?
Yeah, maybe, but so, maybe, just maybe he was giving you like that whole prove them wrong kind of.
Oh yeah, I totally had that.
Yeah, especially well, too, exactly. Think, so okay, maybe he so was. Have,
maybe he's yeah, or she. It was a she.
She not want to do it.
Yeah.
Instead, making you strive to become like the best artist there ever is.
So it's kind of rude, though. My whole art school experience. Oh, it was terrible. And she did it in front of the whole class, and I went bright red. Like, oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's rough.
I wonder if there was anyone else in that class who had like the exact same answer, and they're like, I'm not going to say that shit now.
Like, oh, yeah. Man, crap. Oh, that's the response I'll get? Yeah, I better not say that.
You want to be here to improve your art? That's not why you come to school.
That's not why you go to an art school.
You come here to learn? That's just the wrong answer.
You come here to waste your money on a degree that you can't use.
On a degree that you can't use. So true.
I didn't go to an art school.
I have, I don't know.
I did an art course.
Oh, like, yeah. What's the difference there, though? Like,
The school in specific, I went to Vic Uni because it was close by, it was pretty cheap, and because, I mean, I only went to uni because my parents wanted me to get a degree in something. I knew at that point I already wanted to do, I wanted to do something in comics. I kind of knew my goal, but I didn't really know how to get there yet. But prior to that, it's like, just get something at least.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just have and, a piece of paper.
Right, get a piece of paper because obviously, like, you know, parents are from an Asian country. It's like, if you got a degree, okay, so that's something.
Papers,
yeah, it's like, it's something. And I'm like, well, I decided to get one, which is probably the most useless. I've never used it before. You know, and I kind of had a feeling I would not need it with the, in the career field that path. I was after. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
In comics, you don't really need qualifications in that sense. You just kind of have to prove what you can do with the work that you're doing. So I got that, but like in terms of the question, there wasn't really a moment where like, maybe the first commission that I did, like I never realized that I'm like, oh snap, people will give me money to draw.
This so when was it. Your first commission then?
First commission I would say was after uni.
Okay.
Was after uni, because before then I really had no idea. Like I knew that I wanted to get into comics. I didn't know how it all worked. I used to think, okay, I kind of had an idea that like you have to kind of show your work to them. I didn't really know how to do that, how like where I can do that and to whom I would show it to. But then I was like, I got an idea obviously after uni where I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna hit up a convention, and the only convention at that point that I knew of was San Diego Comic Con. So I was like, I'm gonna hit that. Let's hit the largest convention as the first convention you're doing. So that was definitely something. I was like, okay, how am I gonna get there? Like, I don't have the funds for it. I don't have the funds for it. So what can I do in order to get there? I was like, okay, maybe I can, obviously, if I'm gonna try and rely on my drawing, let's see if I can do something with that. And so I started opening up commissions on like DeviantArt. It's like, all right, if anyone's interested in any illustrations, I've got a PayPal set up. Let's do something. And I got a couple. Obviously, I didn't know what to charge then. I still kind of don't. But
yeah,
then it was just like, whatever. Like, if I can get anything for something, that's still better than nothing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, I've never had a job either. Like, I never had a job. My first job was illustration.
Well, you're like drawing your way to Comic-Con, which is pretty rad.
And I did that. Yeah. I raised the funds to go overseas on commissions.
Wow. That's awesome.
That's great.
So my first flight there, which was 2006, the whole trip was funded by commission work.
That's sick.
That's fantastic.
It was a lot of commissions. Mind you. Sorry?
First to the States as well?
It was my first time in the US. It was my first time traveling by myself.
That's brave, man.
Oh, well, I wasn't really by myself. one of my uni mates wanted to go because he wanted to go San Diego Comic Con. So I like, all right, let's go. Let's both hit up Comic Con because this that was both of our first conventions.
Mm-hmm.
He's the co-writer of Random Views. Yeah, we were like, let's hit up Comic Con.
Oh, okay, cool.
Let's hit up Comic Con, see what it's like. He'd never, I think he'd been to America prior to that, maybe once when he was younger, but that was my first time, and I was like, sweet, I'm gonna do this. Because if I don't do it, then, you know, I can't keep holding it off. If this is something that I want to get into, the industry I want to get into, then.
So how did that go then, your first trip? Like, what was?
Oh, it was amazing. Like, Comic Con was fantastic. I didn't get any work from there. Although, like, technically speaking, I did, like, meet up with Udon then, and that was the first meeting with them.
Okay.
The next year was when I made contacts, in a sense. Like, I met up with a lot of people that I already knew online. So that was kind of the, you know, the thing that I mean, like, you know, a lot of people online through DeviantArt and stuff like that. And meeting them in person is obviously a little bit, it kind of solidifies what you already knew of them online, you know?
Yeah.
That was the first time I met Furay in person, but we had, like, been speaking online, like, I think a year or two, maybe 2-3 years. So it was great, but it was like as if nothing changed, you know?
Yeah.
So you kind of got all that out the way. And yeah, you make contacts and stuff. Like, I knew Joeing from DeviantArt as well. We used to always do jams online, but then he was working for Udon at that point, and he was like, dude, just come by the booth. You know, I'd like to, you know, it'd be great to meet and hang out afterwards. And he goes, I'll let you speak to the editor. So I met Jim there, and he was like, he saw my stuff because I had just a folder of random things.
Yeah,
I did like I did like a random because they were like, oh, show your sequential work. So I was like, all right, I didn't really do comics prior to then. I did like Enter Void, which was that online battle comic type thing.
Yeah, can, yeah.
That was really fun. I used to do some of that, and then I did like a Freakazoid 6-pager because I want to do Freakazoid, and I didn't really know how those script things work. Whereas like, what are you supposed to draw? I didn't realize you can download scripts online and actually just draw them.
Yeah.
But I just made it up myself because I'm like, I want to draw Freakazoid, so whatever. So I had that as an example. But then, like, in terms of Udon, I was like, oh, show us some of your work. And it's like, okay, cool. I showed him some of the work, and it's like, yeah, keep us updated. And so sweet. I did, and, you know, that worked out. But, like, I think the first, I can do this for a living was when I realized, when I found out, oh crap, people will pay me to draw.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was it. Like online when I saw, because I used to see people going, you know, open for commissions and stuff like that. I'm like, what's a commission? Because I'm like, wait, because I'm always just drawing. I didn't realize people were like, oh, I like your style. Can you draw this for me? Here is money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So once I realized that that was actually a possibility, that was a thing, excellent.
Yeah, I'm very thankful for DeviantArt for that. Just being into like that world of, you can make like a side income, but just doing the stuff that you're already currently doing.
Mm.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, blew my mind that people were like, yeah, I'll give you money. It's like, this is weird, but all right, cool.
I remember I got my...
You go.
Yeah. No, you first.
You go. I was going to say my first commission was like, I did a t-shirt design for my friend's band in uni, and it was like the worst design. Like, I can remember the exact kind of design it was, and I was like, looking back, I'm just like, oh my God, what was I thinking? But no, like, that was my first, like, oh crap, like, people give you money if you draw good. Like,
exactly. Isn't that amazing? I was like, wait a second. Yeah. The thing that I love all my life is actually something that I can do all day and somehow afford to buy things. Because, like, obviously as a kid, I used to look at these books and stuff and go, oh, those are awesome. But then it never really crossed my mind that somebody was making those things.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that alone was like, oh, shit, that's right. These guys are doing this for a living. They're getting paid to do those things.
It's pretty freaking crazy.
Yeah, that's great.
Oh, crap. This is not
right. I think my big question as far as, like, income goes, well, you know, making money was easily, got, like, my first convention. I've never made one. And when I saw it and, like, what you could do, and then, yeah, like, the first time I met Jeff, the first time I met Marty, like just as a fan. I was like, this is legit. People are just selling shit and making money. I'm going to do this. Granted, back then, I couldn't draw shit, but I thought I could. So I just did it.
Hell yeah.
That's kind of the better thing about it as well. If you don't know, you can't do it. I'm not going to tell you not.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
I thought for a convention, like, you have to be invited and, like, you have
right,
to have
right. Yeah, exactly.
Quality of art. I'm just like, yeah, when I found out, like, you can just download the form and just off you go, I was like, oh, this is it. Like, cool. I'll do it then. Mm-hmm. Which is great, too, because that's when I made my first comic, because I knew I was doing a comic convention. I was like, I'm not going to go
to
a
show.
Oh,
that's great.
Yeah.
I suck at drawing comics, so.
I love comics.
And this way to draw comics, just keep drawing comics.
But like, I just, like, I can draw characters and stuff. I can't recreate them, like, in different poses. Like, horrible at that. So I'm just going to be like, I'll just do commissions. It's all good.
That's the beauty.
And if I ever get the money, like, just a fuckload of spare cash, I'm going to commission you to do a comic.
Oh, it's gonna have to be a lot of cash because if he doesn't like doing it,
yeah,
it's gonna be a few years, so you got time.
All right, I'll work on my sequentials,
I'll just work on saying no. That also works.
Oh, I could easily say no.
Mm-hmm.
Let's make it legit, but
it makes it a bit harder.
Shit. It really
it
pushed
it a bit harder that it's for Chris.
Was there more questions, you said?
You go, Chris.
I was like, yeah, we just got that one question from Jan last week. But we did talk last week about art theft, so we're going to talk about that this week.
That's right. You're about to go off, aren't you?
Not yet, no. But
not yet? Okay.
Someone started talking about it last night. I'm just like, I literally just don't want to talk about this topic right now.
Yeah.
It was very big to a point. I'm just like, why are you bringing this up with me? Like, I don't want to talk about it. So, but I'm ready. I'm ready to talk about it. And my
you're ready now. You're prepared. You've been preparing for a whole week.
But apparently, I haven't done as much research as Cass has. Apparently, Cass is right into it.
Oh, I did a little bit of research. Well, Kat recommended the YouTube talk done at San Diego Comic Con a few years ago about, I think he handles the legal department for DeviantArt, and it's all about like copyright and when it comes to intellectual property, like drawing pre-existing characters, like say selling prints of a drawing that you've done of Catwoman or Superman or something at a convention and all the legalese around that. So it was a bit interesting. It was almost... I mean, in the end, he says, you know, sort of don't do it, but at this, like, it's not your intellectual property, but at the same time, like, you know, you can sort of do it to a certain extent at a convention. obviously.
Look at what I'm working on.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
That's that falls under parody, doesn't it?
Yeah, I guess. Because it's not like they're legit characters. Like,
yeah, but sort of be prepared that if a company sort of wants to step in and slap you with a fine or whatever, they have the right to. Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Rude.
So, but were we going to talk more about, say, art theft at conventions and things like that? Or just the
like
topic
more
in broad terms?
Where artists steal others?
Like, conventions is definitely like a big topic where it seems to be getting more common. Lately, like, people think that, like, they know how to do some fucking shitty Photoshop filters and that makes them an artist, so they have the right to sell that shit online.
Of course
it
does.
Take, like, other comic artists' work and they'll just, like, add some, like, splats and then be like, yo, buy my print.
Dude,
yes,
that is too common.
That happens so much.
Like, there's people out there who think,
better times.
I got it on Google, so it must be free, right? Like, I can just download it and buy it. It's like, no, that's not how it fucking works.
No, you don't.
Try and make money from it. Like, I get if you just want to
download
like a Facebook avatar or some shit, but if you want to make some profit off just some shit you downloaded off Google, you better do your fucking research.
Yeah. I guess that's the thing. Like, I definitely put into two camps, say, someone who does their own drawing of Catwoman versus someone who takes someone else's drawing of Catwoman and then puts some splatters on it to try and sell at a con. Like, those are two different, very different things.
Yeah.
Splatters, man.
Or it's like, oh, cool. I'm going to trace this photograph, compile it together, print it out really cool, and this is it.
I actually got flamed a few years back. There was someone on Kickstarter trying to sell some posters who used that technique to try and sell these posters and make a Kickstarter for it that was making quite a bit of money. And I actually reported them. Yes, they were going to sell these splatter posters, like there was a Jim Lee Green Lantern and a Adam Hughes something.
You can't do that.
And
you don't own the
artwork. I got them.
You can't do that.
Exactly. And, you know, they don't even own the intellectual property, let alone the,
yeah,
the use
exactly.
of artwork.
They don't own the artwork or the actual property itself.
So I had it removed from Kickstarter, and a few of the people that had backed actually like messaged me and sent me very threatening messages saying that I'm not a real artist, I don't understand, I got in the way of their artistic vision, and all this stuff. Yeah,
that's
but I just
that
I stuck to my
best.
Guns.
That is yeah. the best.
I would have been like, yo, mail me a vial of your tears.
And, you know, they're saying, oh, well, you know, we wanted these great posters for my son's room. And I'm like, okay, that's great. Why don't you go to the original artist's page and order one from the artist so that way you know the artist who actually spent the hours producing that work, money for it.
Mm-hmm. But and see, that's the thing. People don't really care because it's, if I can have this now, I'm going to have it now. I don't care who
the
did it, really.
Instant gratification.
It's the actual, yeah, it's the actual character itself that I give a crap about.
That's dodgy, so.
Yeah.
Oh, well, did they get back to you after you said that? Like, after you said, no. Hey.
So how did people find out that you were the one that...
Because I think I posted a comment somewhere about it, or the original dude who had the Kickstarter found out where I'd reported them or something. I can't remember. Okay. It was a few years ago now.
If the guy was doing it was angry at you, then clearly he knows what he's doing and doesn't give a shit.
Yeah.
That is no respect. So there's no way you should even respect what he's doing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Not at all.
In my experience, when I, like, confronted someone, well, not confronted, but dogged someone in for doing the wrong thing,
mm-hmm.
I just got mm-hmm. fucking blasted by them because they were pissed off that I destroyed, you know, was attacking their
You're attacking their business, dude.
Yeah, it's like, you're fucking stealing shit. Like, what business do you have?
Exactly.
What business? Yeah. The business that you're going to go take this work, print it out somewhere, make money off of it, of somebody else's actual hard work. No. Nah.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck if I'm stealing from your business.
You're bad business ethic. Like, it's...
Exactly. No, that's not
so
cool.
Dodgy.
I think what pisses me off more is actual people out there who are making a viable living.
Oh yeah, there's lots.
And that's, I think that's what angers me the most about it is I'm struggling to even, you know, sell a few prints each week, whereas these guys are just pulling in tens of thousands of dollars at like every convention. It's like, mm-hmm. this is bullshit. And no one's doing anything about it. Conventions aren't doing anything about it. A lot of websites will just sweep it under the rug. Like, I don't know how many of you guys follow Erin Hunting, but her shit gets stolen a lot.
Dude, all the time.
Yeah, so much. And I get it, because her shit is mega appealing. But they don't care. They're just like, I can't delete it. And then that whoever put up the design just goes and makes another page somewhere else.
Exactly. Oh, it's online. That means it's free.
Exactly, man. Like that fucking mentality again.
It must be free if it's online, if I can download it.
And then people get uppity, like, oh, if you don't want your art stolen, then you shouldn't put online. But when so much of our business comes from there, you don't have an option.
Exactly.
Or when people complain, oh, can you upload it without the text? And I'm like, no.
People ask me that?
Run it!
Oh, bro, I'm just going to use it for, like, a background or something. Like,
yeah, and I'm like, you can use it with the text, man. It's like, but it's got your website. I'm like, exactly. Know where it's from.
Now you'll never forget that I did the piece.
Know where it's from. I'm just like, oh, it ruins the image. And I'm like, not for me.
Mm-hmm.
What a
not
dick.
For me. Hey, I'm allowed to, it's like I created that thing. I'm letting you see it, right?
Yeah.
It's up there online. Yeah. You can see
You're
it.
Privileged cool. enough to lay eyes on my masterpiece.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying I'm like, all right,
bow so unto
say,
me.
Say I have a product that's for sale, right? Oh, it's like someone asked me before, can you upload it so I can print it on a shirt? I'm like, why don't you just buy the shirt that I'm a, that actually has a, is available?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, have I? I'm sure I've told you guys this story. It's the funniest thing I've ever overheard at a convention. And it was one of those moments where you just pretty much turned to stone on the spot. I was at my booth and this girl's looking at my prints, this young girl, and her mom grabs her hand and says, oh, come on, let's go. And the little girl says, oh, mommy, mommy, I want to buy one of these prints. Mm-hmm. And the mother says, within clear hearing distance of me and my booth, no, honey, they're too expensive. I'll print you one out for free when we get home.
Yep. I've heard that too many times, dude. I've heard that too many times.
Oh, that gets me every time. I mean, do they just have no tact to not realize the actual artist is sitting right here? Right, I can actually...
You know what I'm noticing, though? A lot of the times, people don't realize that you're the actual person that did it.
Yeah.
Because people still constantly ask, oh, did you make this? And I'm like, no, I stole this online.
I'm actually one of those scumbags that you read about.
Yeah. I find images online, I blow them up, and I make profit.
I'm a professional scumbag. Hi, how are you doing?
Exactly.
Man, I remember doing, was it Manifest with Jeff? And some
dude
printed Gohan piece that Jeff had done. And it wasn't like because Jeff had done piece, like all the Gohans, and he just had the one Gohan image, obviously stealing off DeviantArt, and brought it up to Jeff. And it was the shittest printout. Like, he didn't even go to like Officeworks to get that shit done.
Oh no!
Like, oh, can you sign this? And I'm just like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
bro, have some fucking respect, man.
And I, and I'm like,
no.
Sure. I was like weirded out. I'm like, cool. You printed out my work because you like it so much. You want me to sign your printout, which is like from DeviantArt, so it's super low res.
Yeah.
Low res. Or I'm like, yes, I signed it. I stamped on its, I think I signed its face. I was like, I just ruined your printout, bro, but whatever.
Oh, we have
like
a question
passive
in
aggressive
the chat.
Autographs.
Well, the thing is, I don't care. It's like, how could I give a shit? Like, I can't even say thank you for supporting my work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could say thanks for being a fan.
Oh, we have a question in the chat.
Oh, we do?
Oh, shit.
Yeah. How do you feel about digital artists tracing over art and calling it an original?
No, it's not original.
Yeah.
It's definitely not original.
It's not original.
Like, I'm not going to lie, I referenced a bunch of art for what I'm currently working on, but I'm smashing it together with, like, a bunch of photos and reference to the band. But
you didn't trace it, though.
Yeah, no, I kind of did it all by eye.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, you're eyeballing the piece.
Like, what level are we talking about, though? Like, if you had to draw New York City, so you got a photo of New York City, and then you traced that, an illustrative, you know, design, mm-hmm. like, I wouldn't call that stolen art. Yeah. Especially if you're mashing, like, characters in and cars in, like, you're just doing, you know, you're sort of making an amalgamation into a scene, amalgamation mm-hmm. of art into a finished scene, and then drawing that.
Yeah. This question is, like, tracing over art.
Yeah.
So, I got a Jim Lee piece. I'm going to trace over it. I'm going to vector over it or whatever. That's mine, by the way. Like, all right. Yeah. I'm not sure. You guys browse Instagram and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Images. And this bothers me the most. As a fan of, say, Dragon Ball, I'm a fan of Dragon Ball. Here's what I see a lot, and that pisses me off. They will find an image of any of the characters, vector trace a majority of it, and add, like, trace, like, shoes onto, like, you know, like, modern shoes, like Nike, some Jordans on it.
Holy crap.
Or they'll, like, put camo on it and then write, like, swag or something on it.
Yeah.
And that's art. And I'm like, no.
Like, why?
No.
Why are you doing this?
I need to look at what Instagram you're looking at.
No, I don't look at it because I browse through the search and that's what I see. And I'm like,
oh, you're looking for the tags. Yeah.
It's bad.
Hey, Muddy's in. You made it.
Muddy's in.
Big dog.
He extended the question. He's like, in saying the example, Jeff, when someone traced your hair and flipped the character into someone else, don't do that. If you're learning, fine. If you're learning, if it's all about learning, if it's like, if you credit where your sources are and you're saying this is an experiment in learning, fine. Where are you if you're actually going to make profit from it, I've got the actual YouTube thing open.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
So yeah, like if it's a learning thing, absolutely fine. You could do it, no problem. But if you're going to say, like, if you're making money off of it, you're a scumbag.
Yeah.
Don't trace Akira Toriyama's pieces and say, this is my original. Suck dick. No, it's not.
Well, I've done a few oil painting exercises where, like, I'll take a painting from, you know, some of the old classic masters and try and recreate it with oil paints because I want to learn the techniques.
Yes.
But I'm not, say, then reselling it or saying, hey, this is all my original work. Look at how great I am.
No, like, check it. Like, because I see people do that as well with paintings, and they go, here's a recreation. When people buy it, they know it's a recreation, though. You're letting them know this isn't an original because it's not. And you're not claiming that it's your original. That's fine. That's fine. But when it's like, look what I made, 100% original me. This is my idea. No, you're wrong. You're stupid and you're wrong.
You are dumb and you should feel bad.
I like really it.
But it's worse because they don't know what they're doing is not bad, not a bad thing.
Yeah.
Taking
it's bullshit. And I'm assuming this has come under a licensing issue. But let's say the Mona Lisa, for example, one of the most famous paintings in the world. Yeah. You can go down to a lot of, you know, art print shops or your framers or whatever and probably pick up a copy of the Mona Lisa, which is generally, I guess, like most of the fake ones have like eyebrows and shit or something.
Yeah.
You can just go pick up a print of this beautiful painting that surely someone must have the rights to.
Sure that's been donated to the Louvre, which is like an open museum, which is why people, I think, I don't know, that one would be tricky.
I think with things like that, there is like, you know, when you're buying a print of it, it's not the original. Because if you think it's the original, then you're kind of weird.
You're an idiot. Like, there's no sugarcoating it.
Thrash went, you're weird, but you're an idiot, but Jeff just kind of sugarcoated a little bit.
Like
that. There's no sugarcoating. You're an absolute idiot.
You're pretty much a moron, but...
Yeah.
I think with the things like those reprints and stuff, the actual galleries get the, like, if it's an official, like, official print that you buy from the actual gallery, they recreate it themselves. So it's actually like, this is something that we own. This is something that we can actually reproduce.
Yeah.
Well, I don't mind buying prints from galleries anyway, because I know the sales will help keep the gallery open, especially if it's one that's free to visit. So I'm happy to support them.
Heard that.
All right, there's another comment in the actual live chat. Oh. He's just continuing. He's like, oh, no, I'm saying because I recently talked to Ian McFly. Yeah, that guy, he's a fucking hack. And he was cool at first, but when I saw a lot of his stuff was copying, he became lame. Because he's not an artist.
Oh, yeah, that's the guy that immediately came to mind when you said
he's jacked my McFly stuff before.
He's completely rip-off artist. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, and I'm like, come on, dude. And it's like, oh, he made it into a different... I didn't give a fuck. I don't care how much hours you put into copying this. You still copied it.
Yeah.
Stop
it. Guys, and you can, really stop it. You can see the stuff that he does. Yeah, yeah. Like, that's his.
Oh, and then it's the not... Exactly. And the main thing, the worst thing about it is that people support him still.
Yeah.
That's the part that frustrates me in a sense, because I'm like, cool. So the people who made this prior to him jacking it, they get no credit. They get none of the funds that this guy's making.
Yeah.
Yet he can go away like, yeah, cool. I made this shit. I appropriated it.
Yeah.
That's really sad.
Nah, man. Nah.
And I'm just checking out this guy's Instagram because I remember the bullshit that you went through, Jeff.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, and check
went,
it though. Right?
He actually went private.
He went private after. Like, I've been blocked. And I'm like, I've never spoken to this guy. I've been blocked from his Twitter and his Instagram. This is when someone notified me about the jacking. And I was like, clearly he knows what he's doing.
This is legit the perfect
example
of fucking...
Yeah, because the thing is, he wouldn't block me from his sights if he know if he knows what he's doing isn't cool.
Yep. Legit, man.
Fact.
Look, look at this. All right, I'm posting a link in the live chat.
What I would love to do, right? I know this might be, it's like, oh, you're taking work from this guy. I don't give a fuck. I would love to show all the original pieces he's jacked to the people he's that's employing him.
Oh, yeah.
I really do, because I'm like, check it. You're employing a thief. Have fun with that. If you support this, then you're no better than he is.
Look at how jacked up that design, that print thing that I sent in the YouTube chat is.
I'm gonna check it.
And so, tell me that the rest of his stuff isn't jacked. Like it's.
Oh wait, it's not doing anything, dude. It's just a weird link.
It's because I had to put dot instead of.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, you had to put a dot in there.
Fancy.
That's weird.
I came in late here, so. Can you guys just...
Oh, we're talking about... Briefly. Yeah, we're talking about art theft, Marty.
Okay. All right. I kind of gathered that much. You're focusing on specific right now, yeah? Is that his original artwork?
Sasha Fitzgerald says, hey, peeps, in the chat.
Hey, hey. I have a little story about art theft, if you want to
hear it.
Please. Oh, yes.
Share.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
It's going to be a long episode.
Bear with me, because I'm trying to remember this, but... It was quite a few years ago, and it's actually how me and Chris sort of started talking, I think.
Oh.
Well, kind of. It was very early on in our friendship, right, Chris?
Man, I don't even remember.
I know what you're talking about.
Legit, if you want to ask me about anything in my life, talk to Luke. He can tell you about my life better than I can, because I have the rest.
All right, cool. I remember that. Well, basically, Chris notified me that someone was stealing my artwork.
Oh, yeah.
Tattoo studio that was basically about like 20 minutes from where I live, which was insane. I mean, kind of crazy. So what they had done is they stole some of my artwork and mashed a few things together and basically printed it as a massive banner for the front of this tattoo studio.
And yeah,
you guys might remember this.
Yes, I do.
It was crazy. So I couldn't really believe it. I'm like, what, really? And, you know, Chris, I think you sent me photos, maybe. I can't remember, but I decided to check it out, you know, because it's only 20 minutes down the road. I may as well go have a look. So sure enough, I get there, and I couldn't believe it. I'm like, wow, this is just ridiculous that they've ripped this off. So I'm not, like, the most confident person with confrontation and things like that. Yeah. So it was really difficult. I didn't really know what to do. But I got out of my car, and I decided to just... take some pictures. So I was taking pictures of the front of their shop, and some guy comes out and he's like, what are you doing? You know, because obviously it looked a bit weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, I'm just taking photos of my artwork.
Yeah.
And they're like, huh? They just didn't have a clue. And basically I sort of explained what was going on. Like that's totally my artwork. It's been modified kind of, but it's really just ripped off. And they were pretty oblivious. Apparently they got one of their friends to design this thing.
Yeah.
And he got paid like $500 or something to basically just,
oh my God,
jack your design. Wow.
Yeah. And, but no, I actually did end up talking to him, and
I think we lost him.
Yeah.
Oh no. That's the best part of the story.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Cliffhanger. God, this guy's a storyteller.
I think from memory, I basically made him give me some money. I said, what you did is just fucking wrong. And you just made money out of me. So give me some money and we'll call it even. So he gave me
shit. I didn't know that part.
I'm pretty sure that's what happened. This was years and years ago. So.
Big dick swinging. Give me what I'm owed.
I let them keep it up there because I'm like, I don't care. But it wasn't
a conversation.
Yeah, that would have been an awful thing to find out, though. Yeah. I mean, that's a shame, too. It's not the fault of the people who commissioned the guy to do it, because you pay someone for work like that, and you like to think that they're not going to screw you over and get them into trouble.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's it. I don't think they really knew what he had done.
If you don't mind me asking, which tattoo studio is it?
I don't really want to name names.
Okay. Yeah, no, that's fine. That's fine.
It was in Cranbourne.
Yeah. See, yeah. Like, I might know who.
Yeah. Look, that's I really
that's don't. Okay. No. Don't stress.
Hey, you got money out of it, though. I mean, deserved.
Well, it's not on the shop.
It's not on the shop. They didn't know any better.
I didn't get the shop to pay me. I got the guy to pay me.
You got the artist there, yep.
What's beyond me, though, is that a tattoo shop filled with artists paid someone else to do the art for them? Like, would it sell your own art on there to represent you?
Yeah.
You'd think.
That's beyond me.
I know, it's weird. But that's how it happens.
I will say, though, having apprenticed in a few tattoo studios now, not every tattooist can, like, do their own original shit.
Yeah. They can draw. They can copy. Like, and, yeah.
Yeah, but drawing from one's mind, it's not a skill required to be a tattoo artist. Like, lots of tattoos see, like, they'll do a printout of a photo or something and then do it up.
Which is a skill in itself.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm not, like, downplaying that at all, but yeah, just because you're a tattoo artist doesn't mean you are able to draw something from memory or from your mind.
It's not an automatic assumption that they can kind of create things on the fly on original.
Yeah.
I had one of my good friends is a tattoo artist, basically, like, jack a couple photos for a tattoo of mine. And I was like, oh, this is your process?
Oh.
Yeah,
like, I still got it because I really wanted the design.
Right. But it's like,
I was just like, yeah, that's
it. I could have just done it myself.
I know. I'm just like, not as cool as thought, bro.
Yeah, it's like, you're cool, but, you know, cool points kind of minus a little bit.
Yeah, I don't really risk it.
Cat is saying points. In the chat, best discussion ever. Can you guys explain the difference between being inspired and copying? Because I have a hard time explaining to people the difference. Like, if you develop your own style, shouldn't you be credited? This is an interesting one, and one I actually am a bit impassioned about. Like, I find if you should really come up with your own art style. Like, I don't know if you guys know, you've probably seen him around, but there's a guy on DeviantArt. He pretty much has copied Michael Turner's style, and he gets published. But to me, he's always, if you copy someone's style, you're always going to be the second best version of them.
Oh, yeah, fact.
Because,
yep.
You know, the other artists are still drawing like that, or, you know, late Michael Turner now. But you're also, if you copy someone else's style, you're also copying their mistakes and not giving yourself time to develop your own style.
Damn.
Yep. I feel.
Yeah, I have a friend. I have a friend here in Australia, actually, who's like a world-renowned designer for merchandise. And yeah, his style is very sought after. His name is Stabled. He's really, really good at what he does. And yeah, his style is jacked so hard by so many people, and it's ridiculous. Like, it's just sickening at this stage, you know? Like what goes through someone's head to be like, yo, like, this guy's style is cool, I'm gonna do that style. Like, no. If you want to stand out in a crowd, you need to kind of freaking, you have to do your own thing. Like, as hard as that is, you know, you gotta strive for originality. And that's why people come to you instead of, you know, your neighbor or whatever.
Like,
because you can offer something that they can't.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's me done.
Time to get off the soapbox.
Yeah.
Anyone else want to weigh in on this?
Going back to what Jeff said in regards to, like, learning, like, if you're copying or learn, like, for that pure purpose, I don't see the harm in it. But, like, if you're not going to post it, you know, credit to the artist. But,
yeah,
like, if you're drawing and you're just sitting on one person's style and not trying to at least develop and progress further and just putting together, you know, I understand, like, you take inspiration from a bunch of artists and you just sort of develop into your own.
Oh, yeah, like, I remember when I was a kid, I used to, like, copy Disney pictures and stuff and, like, images from comics to learn, but, you know, that was when I was,
like, 12 years old. Straight up jacking Dragon Ball Z characters.
Same. Oh, my God, I didn't even know.
But, like, I don't know, like, that now, but that's sort of how I started, and I'm slowly moving away, and, like, constantly, like, as I grow older, I discover new artists who are just sort of, you know, appearing in my life, who have probably, you know, been around for years, but I'm still just picking up from them and gathering elements that I really enjoy, whereas, and I'm just transforming that into what I've already got. But if you're just legit just jacking a file and being like, hey, I'm this guy, you know, this is my art and I'm just going to pimp that, like, like you said, people see through it.
They do.
Definitely see through it.
I don't know if there's any solution to it, but I just hope that there's going to be growth from that for that artist.
Yeah.
Especially too, like, I hate to see when artists just sort of plateau and don't move away. Like, the reason I follow people is to watch them grow and get better over time.
Yep.
Yeah, me too. I find that really inspiring, especially if they haven't drawn anything for a while or they haven't posted anything, either they're working on a project that they can't show or whatever reasons they have. And then I see their art again and I just think, wow, like, you've improved so much these last few months. It's just amazing.
Yeah.
That helps inspire me.
Definitely.
Just to make him blush, Marty's a pretty good example of that over the past couple of years.
Yeah.
Bring me into this, eh?
Yeah, Marty, stop being so good at art.
If you want some my opinion, right? Obviously, people still see J. Scott Campbell in my artwork, and I personally, that doesn't bother me because I'm quite confident that I don't look at his work as much as I used to. I don't reference his work. I haven't done anything like that since I was about 13 years old. So we're talking about, you know, over 15 years. Old. Ridiculous. So I've been doing my own. I learned to draw with looking at his artwork and many others, right? So that definitely influenced how I learned how to draw. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Style that I really, really enjoyed. It's definitely not something I would recommend when you're starting to learn to draw, because you do get kind of stuck in that way of drawing, and people always refer, you know, that, oh, you're like that guy. Like, that does kind of bug me sometimes, but at the same time, but I've been doing my own thing. I've been doing this sort of thing for such a long time now. I just don't care. Like, I'm not referencing anyone. I'm just drawing how I need to draw. And that's how I see it. So,
well, at the end of the day, if you believe in your process and you're happy with your process, then screw what other people think. Like,
yeah,
like, that's kind of dodgy as well, isn't it? Like, that could be applied to a lot of people ripping off artists and being like, hey, I'm happy with my process. Screw
I like my process of jacking work, so I want to keep doing this.
Not so eloquently put, just like, if you have no guilt.
What you got to understand, though, guys, is there is a clear difference between jacking off work and jacking off one work.
Sorry, jacking off work. Okay, cool.
And jacking off dudes.
Yeah. Yeah. No, absolutely. I understand what you mean, man.
The difference between a style that you draw.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And ripping off artwork. There's a totally different.
Yeah.
It's absolutely true, though. I mean, you can be influenced by multiple things, and essentially, like, you're not really copying it because it's still filtered through your vision. Mm-hmm. So it's still going to be adapted,
you know,
to what
like
you're doing. Unless you're like, it's a photographic copy, in which case, yeah, it's really not your style. So I don't know.
Yeah. Something that was floating around on DeviantArt, a meme a few years ago, that inspiration map that people were doing, like posting thumbnails of like
five
or 10 different artists of who inspires them. And it was so interesting to see which artists were inspired by other artists, and you could definitely see the influences in their work. So their work was pretty much a culmination of like 10 different people, and you could definitely see it. But again, it was that whole idea that you don't need to take inspiration from one thing.
Nope.
And you can come up with your own style by being inspired by other people.
Yep.
And not just artists too, like I was just thinking before, like, what about artists like photographers? You might like a specific way that they take their photos, or the composition of their pieces that really influence the way you draw cityscapes, for example.
Absolutely.
Or even like oil paint, like people who love, you know, say Van Gogh, and they want to sort of take that art, that painting style, and incorporate it into their illustration.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. I'm just finding this very fascinating topic.
A healthy mixture of all the things that you enjoy. It's nice to see. And I think it's okay to see those. Like you said, Cass, like actually being able to see where those inspirations come from. It's awesome too. It's a fantastic talking point also. Like if you get to meet the artist, like, oh, I see you're inspired by, let's say, from Marty, is it Mucha?
I say Alphonse Mika.
Yeah. It's a fantastic talking point for your fans, you know, sure. to engage with you.
I swear, I don't know anyone who doesn't like his work, though. I will just put that out there. Yeah, pretty popular.
I had no idea about him before Marty, and now I'm just like, this dude's a
bomb. Oh, his stuff is amazing. Well, that's the thing, though. I swear you've seen his artwork somewhere, even if you're not familiar with who he is, because his work is just so prolific.
That's true.
All right.
I'm just getting a bit distracted with my drawing.
Olm said, like, I used to be frustrated because I spent years developing my art and post art every day on Instagram and do original art and always give my own personal take on characters and someone can copy and get praise.
Welcome to the world, man.
Yeah.
That's life, bro.
And that comes down to, unfortunately, those other people just being far better at marketing their product than you are.
They're just more popular, man.
If that's an issue, then you need to be focusing on that as well as your art too. Because if you want to get noticed, like, you can't just expect the art to do it for you.
Oftentimes I see, like, on Instagram, especially Instagram, where they'll post just like a really popular page would post artwork and not credit the work, or sometimes even credit the work, but their post has way more recognition than the person who actually created it. That's just normal.
Yeah.
It sucks, but it really sucks, especially when they don't credit the work. And I'm like, come on, dude, you found it online. Or you found it somewhere. The least you could do is at least search up or even include the name, because it's right there. Sometimes I see people covering the artist's name with their own watermark, and I'm like, that's just disrespectful.
That's dirt. Freaking dirt.
Yeah.
That's just disrespectful, man. Or they'll crop it out, and I'm like, come on, dude. Seriously?
I always get
that, though. Like, I know I've seen that a lot of times, and I'll comment in the post, and then I'll tag the artist. And then I'll message the artist and let them know.
I'll be right back. I'm going to go make a coffee.
Cool, man.
Yeah. Coffee. What am I saying? I'm going to coffee drinker.
In my background.
That's cold, man.
What's cold?
Yeah, the whole, like, jack in work and then, like, not even, like, removing the any evidence of the person's doing. You go make your coffee. Yeah. Enjoy that.
Oh, I will. See you boys on the flip. And girl.
Yeah, that's such a shame when that happens. But yeah, sadly, it's just, again, it's part of posting your work online, and people will try and say all sorts of things. Well, you can protect yourself by not posting your art online at all, again, but it's like, and if people are going to copy someone, yeah, absolutely. Like, you can only just keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah, in terms of going back to, like, being influenced with style and things like that, especially on Instagram, I see a lot of young artists tag me in their posts.
Always.
Drawings that they've basically just copied me, which is fine. I mean, I'm not concerned at all. They're crediting me and everything like that. But my only concern is, like you guys have said before, is that they really do. I see them picking up my mistakes, because I see my mistakes really clearly. I'm not oblivious to them at all. But I can also see it when someone copies me, and it really bothers me that I'm teaching people bad things. Like, I don't want to be responsible for that.
Yeah. I've been in a situation too where I had, a few years ago, a girl messaged me on DeviantArt, and I uploaded this sketch, and she said, hey, do you mind if from this picture, I use this as an inspiration for something. And I said, yeah, that's fine. Like, she was just asking to use it for inspiration. And then she linked me to the picture that she drew, and she'd obviously just printed out my sketch and colored it.
Yeah.
it was fine, but it was obviously not what she was leading me to believe that she was going to do. And, like, she didn't credit me or anything, but she, I mean, at least she told me that she'd done it, but still, I was just a little bit, oh, okay, I wouldn't have called that inspiration, but sure.
For the most
part, you inspired a color, dude.
Yeah, for the most part, like, it doesn't really matter if they're just artists who are young and learning.
Yeah, like, absolutely.
Or than me, particularly. But if they're claiming themselves as, a, as an established artist or a professional, like you guys have been talking about that other guy, you know, there's mm-hmm. no excuse for that.
Nope.
No excuse for
claiming
something else. That's sad when that happens.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I haven't really had that too much, so. I've been lucky, I think.
Sometimes I wonder how much of it gets through the cracks that we just never see as well. Because you can't have your eyes everywhere. It's good when you've got fans who
are. Yeah, absolutely.
Try it for you, but even then, like, they can't. They can't always catch someone trying to rip you off.
And that's the thing, like, I'm not ever going to live in fear of that. Like, sure, if it happens, it happens.
It just, it's unfortunate is all really.
So, was art left the main topic today?
Yes.
Okay. So, talking about our first question is, if you want to answer it, Marty, what did you have a specific point in your life or your art career whatever where you actually realized that you could make a profession of it, like you could, it's a job?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
I kind of always knew that this is what I would do. I know that sounds kind of cocky, but I just
because we kind of all thought that same as well.
Yeah, it's just like I don't know, oblivious, really. It's just, I'm always going to draw. That's just...
That's exactly. It's not even, that's not even cockiness, though. That's more like, yeah. I'm going to do this because I love it. And
yeah, well, there was no, like, there was no option, right?
Yeah, exactly. No one told us not to either.
Yeah.
So I didn't know any better.
But in terms of, like, maybe, like, realizing, hey, this is actually working, I suppose, when I got my first sort of freelance jobs, I think, like, published, that's the word, published
freelance
work for magazines and stuff back in 2003, I guess. So that's probably when I sort of realized, yeah, this is going to be okay. This could be good.
Yeah, it's going to be good. It's going to be all right.
That's great.
Yeah.
So when did you get your first private commission then? Did it sort of happen before you got published work or did you start doing that after?
Private commissions.
All right.
When I was studying, I did a few, like, band, like, geek sort of flyers. That was just, you know, just fun, silly fun
trying
stuff.
To, really. Trying to steal my job?
No, they were much. They were terrible, dude. I couldn't.
Step back, boy. I know you're in Tassie, but I know where.
Wait, he said steal your job. He was doing it before he did this job, dude. So that's how he stole your job. I know. I'm clarifying it, man.
What was the question again? Totally forgot.
Are you trying to
That wasn't the question.
My first, personal commissions. I think actually also during college, one of the teachers commissioned us. He was starting like a little t-shirt company or something. So I did some work for him.
Really?
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it didn't really amount to anything, but it was nice to be encouraged, I suppose.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what I feel teachers should do.
Yeah. If a teacher believes in you that much, like, that's unreal.
Yeah. Also, I guess another one around that time was, you know, the CSIRO,
Science
Education Climate thing. My best friend sort of worked for them and got me a gig just basically drawing clip art for their newsletter, which sounds really lame, but it was kind of fun.
It's still, and it's still art stuff.
Yeah,
job's job.
Almost professional. but that was interesting.
That's awesome. Actually, having heard everyone now, I have had the youngest commission. I was in high school when I got my first.
Okay.
So, I think I was barely a teenager. It was a furry commission back in the day. Nice. Yeah, so someone wanted me to draw the character. I think back to it now. Yeah, I think about how awful it was. But again, it was just to get my first commission at such a young age, I was, you know, pretty flattered by that.
Absolutely.
Especially someone since the person who commissioned me was much older than me. And I was like, oh my God, but I'm like this tiny young artist. I don't know what I'm doing. You know, you're giving me money for something.
I suppose I did stuff back then as well. I kind of just forgot.
Yeah. So long ago. The coolest one I ever did is when I was in high school, even though I wasn't very popular, I was sort of known as the artist person. This guy came in with his bodyboard and he commissioned me to draw a picture on it. I just drew this pin-up style chick with this huge thick marker just on his surfboard. That was pretty fun. And I got to do it during art class for credit.
Nope. That's sick.
You're just making me remember so many more things right now. When I was 12 or 13, there was this guy that I knew through my parents who spray painted cars and stuff. Does that make sense? I don't know what the technical term for that is. But he did like all these crazy airbrushing. He had the whole factory and everything. And he basically
convinced
me to spray paint old factory walls.
That's so cool.
But he paid for it.
Oh, man, I sucked so bad. Yeah, when I did my first.
Can you imagine a 13-year-old with unlimited spray cans? It was not great, but it was fun.
Yeah, I dabbled and I just did skulls and I just sucked so bad.
Yeah, I think
we have another.
Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say we have another question in the chat.
Oh, good.
We have a caller on the line.
Have we ever had? Oh. Do we ever had anyone use their art for random stuff like covers, TV shirt, t-shirts? How did you go about dealing with legal issues?
I'm not that popular, so no.
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
I have.
What did you do?
Steal your art from merch.
You know that Darth Vader, that Thrash Vader that I did ages ago?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so that blew up huge and was on a bunch of different Instagrams. And I put it up on TeePublic. But I've had it ripped off so many times. There was this one site that was called Art Rage.
I know that site. Ugh, I know that site.
Yep. Yeah, so basically, their whole premise is the same as TeeFury and TeePublic. They'd kept to the point where it was annoying. They kept contacting me trying to put this shirt on their site. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden I get a random message one day from a guy going, "Hey dude, don't know if it was you, but someone on this site has used your graphic. You should have a look and maybe even upload it to the site so that, you know, you can claim that it's yours and that it's your your artistic property or whatever."
Yep.
And I'm like, what the hell? This seems really sus. And I'm pretty sure I found out that the guy who messaged me was actually the person who ripped off the design and put it up on Art Rage site just so that he could, you know, sell the shirts. Like, it was so dodgy.
That's so weird though. The person that actually did it is the person that told you about it?
Yeah. So
that doesn't make any sense.
He did it. He told me about it through a different account.
Of course. A different username. But it's not going to be like, "Hey, I just jacked your work. You should get
and
put
so
yours up."
I went on from almost 2 weeks just commenting saying, "Take this down. Take this down. It's my work. Take this down."
Mm-hmm.
Until the point the guy started messaging me and going, "Hey, can you stop?" And I'm like, "Are you kidding me? It was you? That is so dodgy."
Wow.
Yeah.
What a cool day.
That was frustrating.
What's a way to go about it? Depends on which side is doing it. If you can't find the actual artist that's doing it, you actually contact the site that's selling it. Because sometimes they might do something about it. I've had a couple of images. I had that Deadpool riding Flying Nimbus with Goku.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was Jack that uses a shirt. That's everywhere, dude. I contacted the actual website that was doing it. I go, hey, take it down. Here's the actual link to my actual original post. Yeah, I did that. I didn't put that up, so take it down. And they did.
Yeah.
I ended up emailing ArtRage and being like, I have all the PSDs they have all the information in the PSDs saying that I created this.
Not just that, though. Like, here is an actual, I have access to the higher res. I promise you that guy uploaded it was not a higher res.
Yep.
That alone is enough. That's why I think you have to watermark your stuff. It sucks, but that's really like
that's
the only way to go
about
it.
Yourself too.
Yeah.
Like, don't upload high res files of your stuff.
Oh, I never do.
Because
no way.
Able...
Yeah. It's like, you trust people, though. You want to trust people not to do that. So I definitely, like, legal action is definitely contact the websites and see if you can somehow get them to take it down. Prove that it's your work. If you can, I don't even know why you have to prove that it's your work. Because clearly the person that uploaded it didn't do it either.
So I, on that ArtRage ripoff, I'd actually, so I had uploaded this thing to TeePublic in like high res, and I'm guessing they ripped it from there because I put in a watermark, like my logo, like sneakily on the helmet. And then on the ArtRage site, it was there on the helmet. It said Thrashwolf. I'm like, I literally own the domain Thrashwolf.
Oh,
yes,
wow.
On the shirt that this guy has uploaded.
What
you did the math.
What a tool bag, seriously.
Yeah.
The other instance that I had was when they re-released the Battletoads game using a fan art that I did.
Oh yeah.
That one I contacted the actually contacted Microsoft for that, and then the actual people who published the game. They didn't think, when they saw the image, because they were looking for an image to use as a cover, and they typed it up on Google, and I'm like, you can't be serious. Like, that can't be a way for you to release a game, is to go on Google and type in what the game is titled and hope you land on something good.
Or at least hope you land on something that was licensed by...
Right, exactly. And they thought it was... Well, I mean, it's flattering that they thought it was official artwork, but it's also sad that they didn't look into it.
Oh.
You know?
Yeah, that's pretty sad that they don't know if it is or isn't usable.
But it comes down to, like, you don't own... how much do you own of that? Because it's not your property, right?
Absolutely. Well, I mean, with this one, it's like... it was used in... what was that bloody... There's that bloody... shop that sells all those shirts and shit in the US that sells like random things.
Hot Topic.
That's the one. It was being sold as a shirt in Hot Topic.
Oh, okay.
Really?
And they got the license for this thing, and the guy who the people who were putting together the product, just they thought that it was part of the actual official release, so they used it. And I was like, no, I drew that. That was fan art.
That's dodgy.
So they took it off the market. They took the shirt off the market, and I got compensated.
Oh wow!
Good.
That's awesome.
I've got a lot of friends who work for Hot Topic even to this date.
Yeah. Well, the thing that's crazy, it was that We Love Fine. That's the company We Love Fine that do it. The thing that's crazy about that is that before doing that, if they actually had just asked me, they wouldn't have to pay me a thing.
But it's like you going out of your way or like not even.
That's basically it. I'm like, because I'm not credited for it. That's fine. Right, not compensation, not being told about it. Those are too many things that you know that
are not going on, and that's laziness. It's not like they went out of their way to be like,
absolutely,
he is Chamba's shit.
And that's the thing. I don't think like they didn't use it knowing that it was, you know, that it was again. They thought it was official artwork, so they used it. But I'm like, it's got a signature on it. Official licensed artwork don't have the artist's signature on it.
Yeah.
Rarely do they. It's a low res image online. With that, nothing that's crazy. I'm like, if they had asked me prior to using it, they could have had access to a high res image.
Yeah.
And use that instead. But nah, they just printed off a small JPEG.
or effort.
Yeah. So I'm like, I mean, yeah, it's pretty crazy. It's pretty crazy. But what are you going to do? Like, again, it's cool that, you know, we sorted it out and everything, but it would have been better if, you know, they would have just worked that out at the start. Somebody was being lazy.
Yep.
Yeah. Like, they weren't doing it in malice, you know? They weren't doing it...
It was an oversight, but it was a pretty big oversight.
Yeah, it's an oversight. Whereas, you know, where some guys online, like what we're talking about now, where they will actually just jack your work and place it directly on a on an article.
Oh, yeah, that's not an oversight. That's just them being scumbags.
Mm-hmm. They did... there was that website. You see ads on Facebook where it's like Street Fighter clothing, Street Fighter t-shirts. Yeah. There's a couple of the Udon covers that are already popping up on that. And then people ask, oh, did you get it licensed? Like, nah. So we actually, what we did was, we let Capcom know and they took it down.
there's a lot of banned banned merch that's going around on those like Facebook sponsored things that are like horribly crappy versions of like banned merch. Mm-hmm. I've got friends in a band called Die Artist Murder. Who are like huge. They're one of the biggest bands probably in like death metal right now. But yeah, they're notorious for getting their stuff jacked and put on those Facebook kind of sponsored posts or whatever. It's so dumb.
That's terrible.
I don't understand how it can go forward, like how it's let happen, or like how people let it happen and go out of their way to buy shirts from like this dodgy looking store on Facebook.
Yeah, like, again, people just aren't educated, or
they just want the fucking picture.
They don't care. Yeah, essentially, most people.
I mean, you know, like I'm sure the question is in regards. The question that's being asked, obviously, it's like. Maybe somebody, like, if I wanted somebody's artwork on a shirt, and if I had access to the high res, I would make it for myself if it wasn't available. But if it was, if they weren't actually selling it as merchandise, if they're selling it as merchandise, I would support them and purchase that. But if they weren't, and I had access to the high res and whatnot, and I wanted it for myself, I would just make it for myself. I wouldn't make it available for sale.
No.
Yeah.
I would also ask the original guy... like the original creator or whatever, and be like, yo, are you okay if, you know,
I've got a bunch of like unofficial One Punch Man shirts.
Yeah.
These shirts don't exist anywhere. They never will be, unfortunately, and they never have. But I wanted to wear that artwork on a shirt. Is it available public? Not at all.
No.
Not at all.
Yeah, no, all right. That makes more sense. That if it's like a kind of TV show or something, I guess it makes more sense, like, to, you know, kind of do it on the hush. But it's like, it's still like, man, if there was licensed products, I would scoop this up.
And that's the thing. Yeah. If they officially released the shirts that I already own, even as official products, I'd be like, cool, I'm going to buy that.
Yeah. To support
them. The fact that I went out of my way to make it myself.
Should be testament to how much you love.
I fucking love it. Like, I've got like 4 or 5 One Punch Man shirts.
One Punch!
And so people, good. Like, from the original Murata art, and people are like, where'd you get that? I was like, I made it. They're like, oh, I want to buy it. I'm like, make one yourself then, man.
Go through the process, bruh.
Because I'm not going to help you out. I don't know you. I'm not going to be like, oh, cool. I just helped this guy start selling it on his own.
Didn't you meet the artist of One Punch Man as well? Like,
I never got a chance to. No.
Oh, okay.
I wouldn't know what to do. Like, I don't know what to do with my hands. They'd just be like, what am I doing?
Shit off your back. Like, I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'd be like, I love your work. Clearly, I'm wearing it. But yeah, I don't know. There are some things I'm like, I love it. I'm going to, if there's no merchandise of this, what am I supposed to do?
Exactly.
What am I supposed to do?
Just crazy what the industry's done and made, how easy it's made art theft and making an income from it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because there's just people out there, man, who are just thinking, fuck, here's a job opportunity and I'm just going to fucking take it.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate, though.
That's sad, but...
Tell you what, what's not sad is how amazing this coffee is right now.
Imagine having a coffee in this fucking heat. I'm melting.
I've got beer.
This
coffee. Oh, nice.
I'm torn. In front do I get 21 degree fan. Or do I eat ice cream?
Man, I have water, and like even that's warm. And I'm just a bad time up in here.
Ice is melted.
Oh, after the show, I'm having a cold shower. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, yeah. Fact. That's what I'm doing. I was waiting for
Australia
this.
Australia is too freaking
going to the gym
hot.
After this.
I'm just going
to... Oh, you're insane, dude.
Bruh, aircon everywhere. It's the bomb.
Oh, too hot.
Probably would be so hot. But, like, I've got my studio closed up because otherwise, like, you'll hear the baby and stuff. So I'm just like, It's like, it's worth it. For the show. Still for the show.
You're doing one for the team.
Blood, sweat, and tears, guys. All from Chris. Well, mainly just sweat and tears.
Kat just commented and said, I've had art stolen for shirts in China. Actually had a photo of me put on a shirt in China one time. Haha.
That's gold.
What?
That's gold.
That's a whole level of weird.
That's kind of creepy. Like,
but yeah. Just go to China and you're on everyone's body.
Yeah. At that point, though, if it's in China, there's no stopping
girl's
it.
So pretty. Oh.
Yeah, it's done. If it's in China, it's done. It's done.
Yeah. I've had heaps of shirts that I've designed for Blackcraft ripped off and like thrown on AliExpress and stuff. Like heaps.
Yeah, that's so weird.
This is a bit off topic, but like Jazz is a member of those. Like buy, swap, and sell sites for like handcrafters, like who make baby clothes and stuff.
Yeah,
and they're filing lawsuits against Alibaba.
Yeah.
Jacking the photos, reproducing the clothing, and like they're even just taking the photos with like their people's kids onto these.
What the hell?
Yeah, yeah. So
oh my god.
Like they're trolling these groups and just jacking the whole lot. And just recreating all the clothing, so like it just goes way beyond. I'm like, how?
That's
it's
crazy.
Did you guys see the there was a story a couple of months ago of these Alibaba sellers that they found a Kickstarter campaign for like a smart water bottle or something, and they actually made it and released it before the Kickstarter even ended.
That's amazing.
Oh.
That's pretty funny, I thought. I was like, that's messed up because they're just jacking someone's idea.
That's amazing, though.
Yeah. I was like, oh, that dodge, but hilarious.
They managed to make a third-party knockoff and release it before the official release. That is amazing.
Counterfeiting's hard business.
You kind of give him credit for that, though.
Yeah, that's the problem. It's like... Like reluctant clap.
Yeah, it's like that's impressive and scary. That's scary.
I'm surprised I haven't. Well, not that I've looked, but I'm surprised I haven't even tried to jack the Nomad.
I reckon they have.
I reckon they have too.
Like, but you could probably tell the difference. Like in quality, there's no way it's gonna be the same.
Oh no! Like Darren went way out of his way to make ballistic everything, like top of the line everything.
I mean, the product speaks for itself.
Yeah.
I just can't wait to fill larger ones out, man.
Yep.
Because I'm gonna snag that one.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was talking to Darren on Sunday. I was like, yo, when you first released the Nomad, I was like the poorest, like freelancer ever. I'm like, now, like, give me that freaking satchel. I'm going to buy it first up. Like,
yeah, exactly. As soon as that Kickstarter's up, I was like, if the size is right, defo.
Well, he said it'd fit like the 16-inch mobile studio pro.
He said he's trying to make it so that, because I was talking about 11 by 17s.
Yeah.
Because that's what Americans use primarily, like comic artists and stuff. And he was like, if you can somehow manage to fit that in it, because like I've got a messenger bag. It's quite a large one that can store that. And he's like, if you can compete with my current messenger bag and be the same quality as the current Nomad, that's an automatic purchase.
Yeah.
Oh, like the whole system where you can have it make it into a backpack, that's perfect as well. You can carry however you want. Too good.
Oh, we have another question in the chat. Probably it's the last one we have time for before we finish. But it's, if you see someone jacking your art and not giving credit, do you politely message them and explain why they shouldn't do that or blast them so they'll learn a lesson?
I would message them first.
Yep.
Yeah, message first. I'd be nice and first. If there's no response in like a few days or anything, yep. I would rip their asshole apart.
Like, absolutely. I would attempt to message them as politely as I can and ask them why. I'm more curious why they're doing it. And obviously then, yeah, if their response is garbage or they're calling me out, they're calling me an idiot, I'm like, yeah, I'm just fucking putting you on blast everywhere.
Yep.
Everywhere.
I'm going to take this a bit on to the right here. But for people who have had their art jacked, right?
Yes.
And then they end up in that situation and ask someone to take it down and they're just being absolute buttholes about it.
Mm-hmm.
So they put them on blast. They, you know, get their image out there and they say, hey, this person's jacked my art. Please contact them and whatnot. And then as a community of artists, like, there's no way I'm not going to share that if I see that. Like, I'm going to...
Oh, yeah, yeah. For sure. Artist,
right?
For sure. If I see it happening, I'm going to share it.
I've noticed. I don't think this is a bad thing at all. But, like, in anything, like, it's kind of a good thing that it happens because I start to see these artists build a massive following because of what they've had to deal with.
Yep.
And I find that crazy. Like, it's such a shit situation, but such a fantastic outcome for them.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no question here. I'm just sort of stating that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just curious, have you guys seen similar pattern?
Yeah. Yeah, I would agree with that. I've seen that happen before, and
I have seen those people that were in a wrong being defended by people who still like their work, which I don't get.
Yeah, I don't get that either, to be honest.
How can you defend knowingly? Somebody go, oh, they only did this and that. I'm like, they still did it.
Like, no. There's no gray area.
That. Yeah. Is it study? Again, if it's for study and you're crediting them, fine. That's great. Great. If you're not crediting them and you're making profit, you are wrong.
Yep.
You're wrong.
You done goofed, man.
No, there is no right in that. There is no right. It makes it worse. It's like if they're cocky about it.
Yeah. Oh,
no. No.
That's what happened on that Art Rage site. The guy started deleting all the comments that I was posting on my shirts that he was uploading. And he kept deleting them. And then all of a sudden he commented saying, hey, Thrashwolf, I could do this all day. And I'm like, I'm working all day. Let's freaking go, bro. Like, so I'm like spamming the crap out of him.
The thing that I don't get is I would have screen capped all of that and sent it to Rajon. Yeah, and sent it to Rajon and go, hey, check it. You've got a scumbag.
Yep.
Get him out. But
the thing is, the guy was part of Rajon's like staff. That's what's messed up.
What?
I would have put Rajon on blast then. I would have put Rajon on blast.
Yeah, I did on Facebook, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, the more you speak about this, the more I remember.
Yeah.
It's happening to you, man.
That was weird.
It's like, cool, man. I thought it's about supporting artists. That's crazy. Right. Right.
Yeah, right? They just want the best products.
Yep. Bullshit.
Which are artists submitted, but they can't get because the artist doesn't want to post it on their site.
Yeah, the fact that he's actually on it, that's the worst.
Yeah.
That's the worst. That was dodge.
Alright. Whew, heated.
Yeah.
This coffee isn't helping me like to calm down.
Is it an iced coffee?
No, it's just coffee. I've got aircon, man. Like,
man,
he's not a problem for me.
Man.
Heat is not a problem for me either.
Yeah.
Screw you, boy. This conversation is making me heated more so than the heat itself.
It's firing up your rage systems.
It is, man. That's good, though. It means I'm alive.
That's my secret. I'm always angry.
Exactly.
What would you guys do if you get to the next con and you saw someone with a booth with your print up there?
I would call them out.
I will call them out, and then I will actually report them.
Yep.
Yeah, I would actually go talk to them first, and then depending on the outcome of that, then I would go to the con organizers and try and either get the merchandise removed or get them removed.
Yeah, fuck that. I'd just get them kicked out.
No hybrid for Chris.
Like, bro, you've seen how big I am. Like, 8'7" over here, gonna knock some heads.
See, I'm not even about the whole physical stuff. I'm not gonna get into that because I'm like,
if need be, last resort.
I will report him. I'm like, this is not cool. And then I would put him on blast online.
Has anyone ever actually experienced that though?
Me?
Not at a con I've been at.
No, okay. I don't. No. I've seen people report to me saying, "Hey, these guys are selling your prints," and I'm like, "Who are they? How?" I just kept saying, "I'm like, don't buy off them because it's low quality shit."
Yeah.
It's like it's got a watermark on it. No,
I'm assuming it's like international shows.
It's usually like it's a bunch of international stuff. Yeah.
Like,
it'd be amazing if locally, dude. That'd be amazing.
Well, that's why I was so surprised that the tattoo studio 20 minutes from my house was stealing my artwork. Like, I just
right. That's so random.
Yeah. It just blew my mind. Like, you didn't even bother to like research where the artist you're ripping the work from lives. Like, it was common knowledge. I'm from Melbourne. Like, you know, weird.
Not enough common knowledge for them, though.
Nah, they obviously didn't read anything.
Holy shit.
Steal the stuff.
I just figured out a cool thing to do.
Woohoo!
Is it jack off art?
No. So
maybe I'll leave that down, am I?
No.
Like you overlay like a color dodge layer, and then you can delete like your hard shadows from it, and it looks sick. Like this kind of combo. I don't know. So this is it before. This is just like highlights and some shadows, and then you slap on the color dodge and then delete the shadows from it.
Ooh.
Came out good.
I couldn't really tell, to be honest. I couldn't see you change anything.
All right, well, thanks for noticing.
I can't even see your screen for some reason.
Yeah, hold on.
Really?
I got to click on you. Can you turn the layer on and off for us?
Yeah, so.
Oh, Kat brought that up. How do you feel when people say it's flattering when your work is copied or stolen?
Oh, what?
Tell those people to go jump in a river. Get lost. You're not my friend anymore.
Flattering.
Flattering.
I should be flattered that someone stole my work. I'm like, I want to smash you in the face. Be flattered. Be flattered that I notice you enough to smash you in the face. Cool?
And we also had a question, what's the topic for next week? I guess it depends. Whatever you comment on the video. Yeah, I mean, we're pretty much happy to answer whatever questions we get from the end of this episode till next week. So, yeah, fire it at us.
We're doing the same time every week. So, yeah, whatever questions pop up, we'll answer. But usually we'll have a topic prior to then. And I'm assuming that one of the comments will, like, when somebody watches, they'll probably leave a comment and stuff, and hopefully we can talk about that.
Yeah.
Boom.
Absolutely.
Flattered. I'm flattered that you stole my work.
Oh,
I'm going to make a shirt that says,
so
I'm flattered that you
jacked
my work.
It makes me feel like I'm really good.
What?
Like. All right, Marty.
Yo.
So this is a normal just like color dodge layer. Can you see my screen now?
Yep.
All right. And then this is without. And then when I delete the stuff from it, like this kind of stuff happens. And it looks sick, I reckon.
Yeah.
It just adds another kind of dimension.
Yeah. I love finding out little tricks like that that you don't usually think of.
It's just like
so many layers.
Yeah. Oh, well, these are like, I'm only using like these.
I know, because you're a bunch of them are experiment layers, right?
Yeah, experiment layers and like backup layers in case I need to go back to flats or the layered files or anything. All right, I'm actually gonna.
I think we're
off.
About out of time too.
Yeah, I think we're about good. That was a lengthy About an hour and a half-ish.
That's a mutual, I think.
Normal for us,
yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm keen to just, like, rub my body on a cold shower.
Yeah, I'm doing that right after this.
Rub it in general.
I'm going to rub my body under the shower. There's no water. I'm just going to rub it.
Rub it.
Well, thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. And it was awesome having Thrash on the show this week.
Yes.
Hey,
and Marty pop in too. Yeah.
Be happy to come back.
Pleasure as always.
Yep.
Shoot us the topic for next week.
Drop that shit in the comments.
Mm-hmm. Wait, how do we normally exit? Is this we talk about what we talk about something when we exit? I'm forgetting.
Where can we find everyone online?
I'm still Custer Bean on Instagram.
Okay. Ladies first then.
All right, well then I'll go second because
ladies first still. Go.
Thrashwolf on Instagram. That's me.
Thrashwolf.
So Thrashwolf with no vowels. Shut up.
Thrashwolf.
Leave my vowellessness alone.
Marty?
You can find me at Abelot on Instagram.
Crunchy.
Oh, yeah. I'm on the Chamba on Instagram, Twitter, and stuff. Yep.
Cool.
All right.
Where Chris is from.
Oh, sorry. I'm Chris. you're on my channel, so you can just find me.
Right, right.
Hit that subscribe button, folks. Hit that
subscribe. So you can subscribe to the Art Bastards every week.
Actually, yeah, if you subscribe, you'll get notifications each week that we're doing live. So.
Yeah. That's what it's cool.
You can watch all my other cool videos, too.
Right. Other cool Chris videos.
Every day.
I know. What a champion.
I know, man. 40 days in a row today.
I know. You're a legend, dude. That's legend status right there.
I'm exhausted.
You should be.
Yeah. Cool. Thanks for watching, guys.
Cheers, guys.
It's been fun. Catch you later.